Weldments are a quick and easy way to model just about anything that is cut from length. Unlike an assembly file, where each individual length of material would be its own part, weldments use multiple bodies within a single parts file, allowing for faster creation and greater control of the entire frame's shape and size. We're going to walk you through the steps required to go from a blank document to a fully complete trailer chassis, using weldments as the primary modelling tool. The starting point for any weldment is a sketch, and this sketch is a stick outline of where your lengths of material will eventually lie. Let's begin by creating a new part file and starting a sketch on the top plane. We will place a center rectangle about the origin and then add in a horizontal midpoint line, centered on the lower edge of the rectangle. Sketch a center line vertically upwards from the origin and place this outside of the rectangle boundary. Sketch a small vertical line over the top of this center line, ensuring it lies fully outside of the rectangle boundary. This will become the tow bar. Add in an angled sketch line snapped to the midpoint of the tow bar and snap to the left-hand side of the rectangle. Finally, sketch in a horizontal line directly across the middle of the rectangle, snapping to each midpoint. We then need to add the dimensions. Select Smart Dimension from the Sketch tab. The height of the rectangle is 2.5 meters. The width of the lower midpoint line should be 2 meters with a 300 millimeter offset from the outside of the rectangle. This can be positioned on either the right or left-hand side of the rectangle. 750 millimeters between the angled bracing and the top of the rectangle, and 500 millimeters for the length of the tow bar, with a 150 millimeter offset from the top of the rectangle to the underside of the tow bar line. If you pause at this point, you can see all of the required information for the sketch. When you're done, exit the sketch. To access the weldment features, you will need to enable the weldment tab. Right-click on any of the existing tabs and make sure weldments is ticked. Choose structural member. Pick ISO for the standard, C-channel for the type, and 120 by 12 for the size. Click on the left-hand side of the rectangle and the profile will appear down the sketch line's length. This profile can then be rotated, mirrored, and positioned using the options towards the bottom of the properties dialog on the left-hand side of the screen. To position this first structural member, use the Locate Profile button to snap to the top left-hand sketch point within the C-channel profile sketch. If you require multiple structural members that are the same profile type and size, this can be achieved by using a new group rather than creating a new feature. Choose New Group and position the corresponding profile on the right-hand side of the rectangle. You will need to rotate the profile through 180 degrees and then locate, again using the Locate Profile button, snapping this time to the top right-hand corner of the sketch point within the C-channel profile. Choose New Group again and position the central bracing. The profile will need rotating through 270 degrees and positioning using the Locate Profile button, snapping to the center sketch point of the profile. We're going to add in some more structural members. This time they will be rectangular, so we need to add in a new structural member feature. Choose structural member, pick ISO for the standard, rectangular tube for the type and 70 by 40 by 5 for the size. Position this profile along the back bracing, the tow bar, and the angled bracing. Each of these will require a new group and to be positioned using the locate profile option. Angled bracing needs to be trimmed back where it meets the side rail. This can be done using the Trim Extend tool found on the Weldments tab. Select the body to be trimmed, which in our case will be the angled bracing, and then select the inside face of the side rail as the trimming boundary. The angled bracing is split in two, allowing you to discard the smaller piece of material. As with any SOLIDWORKS model, making the most of symmetry will speed up the design process. Here, we're going to mirror the angled bracing about the right plane. Choose the mirror feature from the Features tab and select the right plane in the Mirror Face Plane dialog box. Make sure that you're mirroring bodies rather than features. There is a specific selection box for this. Click on the bracing to populate the selection box. Green tick when you're done. We'd like multiples of the back bracing to be equally positioned along the length of the chassis. Rather than modelling each bracing individually, we will use a pattern. Choose the linear pattern feature from the main features tab. In the first selection box, select one of the edges that runs the length of the side rail. This sets the direction for the pattern. Scroll down to the selection box named Bodies and tick this on. With this selection active, choose the back bracing. You should now see a preview on screen, but the spacing and instances are not yet set to the values we need. Toggle the radio button under Direction 1 to Up to Reference. Some new options become available. The first is a selection box. Choose the end face of the side rail at the opposite end to the back bracing. Toggle the next radio button to Selected Reference. A new selection box will appear. In here, select the side face of the back bracing. Choose Number of Instances for the next button down and set the value to 4. What we have achieved here is uniform spacing along the length of the side rail. If the side rail changes in length, the bracings will automatically move too. Currently, there is no material specified, so next we need to apply one. Right-click on the material from the Feature Manager and choose Plain Carbon Steel. This changes the appearance and the weight of the part. Using weldments is a really quick way of adding in cut from length geometry, but one of the other main benefits is that it automatically creates a cut list. In the Feature Manager, on the left-hand side, you will see the Cut List folder. Expand this to see the cut list items. Right-click on any cut list item and choose Properties to view all of its information. We would like to create a 2D drawing of our frame, but before we do this, we need to save the file. Choose Save and give your file a name. I'm going to call mine Chassis. Once saved, choose Make Drawing from Part from the File menu. When prompted for a template, choose A3 ANSI Landscape. From the view palette on the right-hand side, drag and drop a right-hand view onto the paper space. As you move your cursor, you should see that the other projections become available. Move your cursor upwards to position a top view and then left-click. If you then move your cursor out at an angle, an isometric view will appear. To break the 45 degree alignment, hold Control on your keyboard before placing. The views look a bit too small, so we will change the sheet scale. Hit the upward arrow in the bottom right hand corner of the screen and choose User Defined. Then set the scale to 1 to 25 and hit OK. The cut list information from the part can be inserted into the 2D drawing, and this is done by choosing Weldment Cut List from the Tables drop-down on the Annotations tab, selecting a view and then hitting the green tick. You should then find that the table is on your cursor and can be positioned on the drawing. The corresponding item numbers from the cut list can be shown on the drawing views too, and this is done by selecting a view and choosing Auto Balloon from the Annotations tab. Finally, let's add in a few key dimensions to the model, capturing the width and the length. Use the Smart Dimension tool from the Annotations tab. This is the same dimension tool that we used in the sketch environment. Currently, the frame length is 2.5 meters. If we make an adjustment in the part file, this change is instantly seen in the 2D drawing. Toggle back to the part file using the Window menu. Click on the first sketch in the Feature Manager and change the 2.5 meter dimension to 2.75 meters. Toggle back to the drawing, again using the Window menu. Notice the updated dimensions on the drawing views and the changes to the cut list lengths. If your dimensions or cut lists haven't updated, try hitting the traffic light icon in the top middle of the screen. This prompts a rebuild. This is just a small example of some of the functionality available within SOLIDWORKS Weldments. But if you would like any more information, make sure to get in touch and we will be happy to help.